shave again today, boy. You see it filling in. Oh no, buddy, it's time to shave. So, for those of you guys who don't know, decided to sell my 600 just because I keep driving it like an asshole, and I think we all knew that was coming. That I was gonna, the more comfortable I got with it, the more I was gonna want to drive it like a dickhead. So I decided to sell it, get something slightly smaller. I wanted to get a cruiser. Then I'm like, fuck, man. The whole reason I bought a sport bike was because of the way the tank was positioned with my hernias. It actually holds my hernias in while I ride, whereas a cruiser doesn't do that. I keep forgetting the logistics of all this. So I'm actually going to buy a smaller bike. I'm actually going down to something a lot smaller just because I keep driving like a dick and I'm gonna kill myself. I keep telling myself it's the whole reason that I didn't want to go up, but then I got the power of the $600. Like, I love this power. So I'm actually gonna go slightly down. We're gonna downgrade to a Ninja 250, but I am buying a newer one, so it's gonna have all the bells and whistles and all the good stuff. So I'm going to pick up the new one. We'll take a look at it when I get it home. So yeah, let me go pick this up. My 600, I'm actually just did a full service on. I'm actually getting ready to replace the coils on it and the spark plug. So I'm gonna make a video and then I'm gonna post that for sale after I finish that up. So that's ready to go. You know, make $3,200 off that bike if I can. Probably more around 2,800, but it is what it is. But it'll pay for the new bike. So that's the point, is it'll pay for the new bike. So I'm going to get the new bike. Let's go have some fun here. Dan needs to just step it down. I keep getting crazier and crazier on my bike. And I'm like, God damn, this is the whole reason that I didn't want a sport bike. But then the thought of the power of a Ferrari, instantly, I love the idea. And I keep using that power and it's going to kill me. And I just need to slow down. So I'm turning 35 here. Very shortly. This is my birthday present once again to myself, as I'm turning 35 and I just need to slow down. And Dan needs to remind himself he's not a young dude anymore and needs to slow the fuck down. So let's go buy something that'll slow me down but still look sporty and still have some fun. Right? Right. Let's go. Quick stop at the Wave Sub. The guy I was going to pick up the bike from said he wasn't ready yet, so I told him I'd grab some lunch and then we'll head out.
So there you go. That's the newest addition. It's a Ninja 250R from 2012, I want to say. Super clean. Got it for a good price. So it's already got custom Leo Vincent exhaust on it. It's had a bunch of work done to it. Buddy already changed all this over. Got it for like super cheap. And so that works out. So now I'm going to sell my big boy before it kills me, because that one's too fast. I wanted something that was going to slow me down and still look nice to cruise on, have a good sound, and still rides high. This is actually a fairly good-sized bike. I like what they've done with the 250 class. I like that they've broadened the body, given it a more aggressive profile, made it look more like the big boy Ninjas. And, yeah. So, bought that for $1,000. And then bought that one for $100 with a title. That's a 2021. And then this is a 2004 600. And so I'm gonna replace the coil packs on this today, and then we're gonna sell this for like $3,200 to $3,500. And yeah, so I got the coils over there, so we're gonna do that. And yeah, should be good to go. This thing runs like a top, man. I'm actually really happy. It's got 20,000 miles on it. Runs like a top. Super clean. Super duper clean. Once it warms up, yeah, comes right down into a nice little idle. Probably turn the idle up just slightly, but it is idling slightly low. What are we at here? Oh, that's not too bad. We're about where we should be. Might be able to bring it up just a little bit more. Let's adjust the idle here. Oh, that took it down. Let's go up just slightly. About right there. That might be just a tad bit too much. Let's do one turn like that. There we go. Perfect. It's about 1500. About where it should be idling. Nice little Leo Vincent pipe on there. Sounds good. Good. Got a little vacuum leak I can hear. Gonna have to find that vacuum leak, because when I hit the throttle it takes a minute to come down. So we got a small small vacuum leak I gotta track down. It's probably a dried out vacuum line or one that's been disconnected, but I took it for a ride. Cruise is good, so not bad. 2012, these things still sell for like $2,800 used. So I've seen these things make it all the way to 110,000 miles before they need a rebuild. This one's only got 20,000 on it, so good to go. Okay, let's take this thing for a rip. I only have front brakes right now. I need to resolve the other brakes, but see how this thing does here. Go out on the main strip. Ah, this feels good. This feels pretty darn good. Gotta remember, I only have front brakes. Keep going for the rear one and it's not there. Yeah, that Leo Vincent pipe sounds actually really good. Let's see here. Let's open this thing up a little bit. Looks like red line's at 12, so let's give her some beans. Not super fast, sounds good. Nice little sporty bike. I'm digging it. See how she handles. Yes, sir. Bike pulls pretty good. It's not bad for just a little 250. Pretty quick little bike. Sounds good. What are we waiting on here? This will definitely slow me down. I still get to have some fun, get the sport bike feel in there, all that good stuff. This will keep me under the radar. This will keep me from wanting to hurt myself. There we go. See if I can shut it off here. There we go. Leave it in gear. Leave it in gear. Alright. I got my Seafoam. Let's go. I'm going to take the long way back. This thing sounds so crazy with that Leo Vincent on there. Hey, hey. But so far, so good. Seems to be shifting fine. Everything's fine. Can I just come out here? Hell yeah. Let's just go for it here. Hell yeah. This little bike gets it. However, I think I just had one of my loops come off. Damn it. Come on, man, I want to downshift and hit it hard. I don't even think I have to downshift. There we go. Hell yeah, they're 60. Yeah, this bike will get up to speed pretty quick. I'm not even hammering on it too hard, so. These little 250Rs, man, they're pretty quick little bikes.
Drop her right down in the RPM band. Take her all the way to the bottom. Got enough power to get you in trouble if you want to. Something's rattling up here. I gotta find it. What's up, tree? Yeah, it's got enough power to get you in trouble. Like a great bike to hit the corners in, you know. But it runs good. So let's run some seafoam through the engine here. Let's run a little seafoam through her. And I definitely need to work on this shifter. Getting caught up on the bottom. I can see where it's getting jammed sideways. It needs a little work. When you're moving to shift, it's easy to get it back into neutral. When you're down like this, you gotta kind of fumble with it to get her to go back out, unless you're trying to go up in gears while it's already moving. So this shifter paw definitely needs some adjustment. See what I'm saying? How it doesn't want to come out? It's because it's getting kinked down here at a weird angle. It's not settling right. So it's not able to put the proper amount of pressure to get this out. This needs to be readjusted. I need to see how it's got a ton of tension slack in it. It's messing with the shift bad. That needs to be all corrected horribly. A lot of play down there. Once it's out, clutch is working good. Once it's out, see, and then it goes into neutral. So there's, when it's running, there's too much slack in this to actually shift properly, so it makes the shifts feel really weird. So needs a little bit of work. Needs a little work. But other than that, this is a good little run at 250. We're gonna run some stuff through the tank. Give this thing a proper cleaning because it needs it really bad. Take these plastics off here, repaint them black, clean up the bike real good, give it a wax, and I think this thing will come back to life. And then I need to address this rear brake. Because I don't have a rear brake right now. This plunger is shot. So it's either low on fluid, which it might be because I don't see any fluid in here. I don't think I see any fluid. Oh, this has a stopper on it. Okay. So I need to take that stopper off before I can go any further. But yeah, this plunger has no compression whatsoever, even pumping it. So the front brakes work really well. You hear the squeaky shock. You hear the springs in there? That all needs to be lubricated. Oh boy, so does the clutch lever. This needs to be dropped back to a 3 instead of a 6. I don't know who was riding this thing, but man, they must have had some big hands. So, but whatevs. Let's get a little 2012. Let's work on it.